back, Pat.
Yeah, I bet you do, Darren. Yeah, you got some good people helping you there, Pat. You got Doper Darren up there that gets drunk off his ass and uses drugs on a daily basis. You got Liar Darren over there who smokes pot on a daily basis and he works the system any way he can to avoid paying taxes and make money under the table. Yeah, you're hanging out with a good crowd, Pat.
My car. I knew whose it was and where it was.
That's right. Exactly. You know, that's the reason why the police officer didn't believe him and arrested him. And his don't give a shit, Darren. Under 2.5. Who cares?
You ratted him out, Jeff. You're a rat. Let's face it.
I'm a rat.
You better run, Pat.
Jeff is a no-good-for-nothing rat.
You are a rat. All I did was rat Joe out, which he should have been ratted out a long time ago. And I'm sure
W-O-9-E.
He's been ratted out many, many times before and many, many times since.
I've never ratted on anybody in my entire life, Pat.
Driving law and
talking. Ever. I have never ratted on anybody in my entire life, Pat, for anything.
Continue to do this. My spewing hate is...
Not arguing with these fucking retards. N9FRE.
Yeah, well, that's his M.O., though. He just can't help himself. He's addicted to those pills. And when he goes down the street and gets them.
And where do I get them?
Take me home, Darren. I need some more pot.
You have to ask Jeff, man. Jeff knows where to get them. He gets them when he's... He'll be leaving here in a little bit to go get him because he's worked up pretty bad right now.
Yeah.
What did that crop do this year, Darren? That crop of weed you grew out in the Hoosier National Forest. Did you get several pounds out of that this year? That probably supports you. That'll make up for your taxes, like you said that one day, right?
That's right.
Jeff is a rat.
There you go, people. N9FRE 73.
Watch out when you see him coming. He may well be intoxicated.
Yeah, we have to mow it like hay, man, and run it through balers, man. Oh, Jeff just worked up. Maybe we need to ease off him or he'll be doing an overdose. Listen, man, go in there, man. Call your wife, tell her to come home from work, and go to the refrigerator and get you a big old jug of milk and a bunch of cookies.
Yeah, that'll kill those cravings for that alcohol for a minute.
And those pills, man.
You guys are jealous because you got to use substances to alter your mind because you can't cope with your miserable lives. So you smoke pot, you drink alcohol, or in Pat's case, I don't know what his case is. He's early Alzheimer's is what that is. But like I said, Darren, you guys just enjoy your marijuana and your alcohol and such. And, you know, just keep altering your mind so you can put up with your miserable lives.
73 and 9 and 40. He's the one calling us a bunch of
potheads.
He's the guy that's busted with the weed.
Ah!
We ran him on.
I just got an email from a federal law enforcement guy, and he said he couldn't believe what Darren just said out here.
Wow. Yeah, I know. It's unbelievable.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you know what that means? The word unbelievable means they don't believe it. You're right.
He's a fed, Darren.
That's good, man. I'm glad he's a fed. He ought to be taking account of you and Jeff, man, running them drugs back and forth.
Yeah,
it just slowed your thought process down a little bit, didn't it, Darren?
I'm worried, man. They come here, they're going to be off the board. They're going to say, oh, my God. Oh, my God.
You want to keep running your damn mouth when you got ghosts in your closet.
That's right.
Those pills like Jeff and Joe's got.
Yeah, well,
I'm like, no, I don't need those things, man. I'm all
natural. Drug violations, anything else?
I use my pills. I'm 71.
Anything else, Darren? Come on.
How about some firearms violations, Darren? Let's hear some of those.
We don't have no firearms. We got pellet guns, BB guns, silencers.
There you go. That's a good one.
That one there will get you in trouble unless you have a... you have to record each gun. If you put them on a gun, you got to register that. You can't just buy one tag and fits all. It doesn't work that way. I know where Jeff and Joe do that. They run them guns and them drugs back and forth.
Shaving.
That was his explanation on 3810 the other night. When he explained
his friends why he got a domestic battery. But he told the whole story, and she beat herself with a dumbbell. I mean, it looked like he beat her up.
He got fired from John Deere, man, for being on those drugs, man, those drugs.
Well, that shows how much he knows.
Yeah, me and Boeing hired him, man, as a janitor.
Sure, freaking worked at John Deere.
And he didn't stay very long there either, but old Jeff got fired from
John Deere, man,
from taking them hard drugs.
Sanitation engineer. Over.
Janitor.
How many pounds did you get from that harvest this year, Darren? Is that going to be enough to support your needs for the year? Over.
We don't care about that.
People walk all over you. What's the point?
We don't care about nothing but interference out here, Tom. Perpetually.
We don't care about that.
Well, Joe would say we're sharing the band.
That's right.
We don't care about
that's
that.
Exactly correct. Learn, Pat.
And good morning.
That's what I'm going to tell him. If I get a letter, I'm sharing the band.
D-S-T.
Roger that.
Enough of quiet over.